Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about reference or standard electrode. So what is reference or standard electrode? It is the electrode which has the non-electrode potential, as I have already discussed regarding standard electrode potential. So standard or reference electrode having some defined electrode potential. So potential of this electrode is known as half cell potential constant. For example, standard hydrogen electrode having the potential of 0.00, zinc is having the potential of minus 0.76, copper is having the potential of plus 0.34. I have already discussed about standard electrode potential in my previous video. Link is given here. Now coming to the next point. So this reference electrode is completely insensitive to the composition of solution under the investigation or solution under the study. So with this reference electrode, working electrode or sample electrode is conjugated, and a sample electrode will measure the concentration of the analyte present in the solution. Now coming to the ideal characteristics of the reference or standard electrode. So first ideal characteristic of this reference electrode is that it obeys the Nernst equation. So this reference electrode obeys the Nernst equation, and as you know, I have already discussed the Nernst equation in my previous video, and the link is given here. So you can watch my video for Nernst equation. Now second characteristic of this reference electrode is that it exhibits constant potential throughout the analysis. And the third characteristic of reference electrode is that it exhibits little change with temperature cycling. So these are the ideal characteristics of the reference electrode under standard condition. And what is standard condition? Concentration of the solution should be 1 molar, temperature should be 25 degrees Celsius, and the pressure should be 1 atmospheric pressure. Now coming to the types of various reference electrodes. So there are mainly 3 types of reference electrodes used in analysis or in potentiometry. First one is standard hydrogen electrode, second one is saturated calomel electrode, and the third one is silver chloride electrode. So I have already discussed about standard hydrogen electrode and saturated calomel electrode in my previous videos. Now in this video I am going to discuss about silver chloride electrode. So silver chloride electrode is a type of reference or standard electrode. So first I will draw a block diagram for silver chloride electrode.
So this is the block diagram of silver chloride electrode. So here one AG wire will be there, and this AG wire is coated with AgCl, and here 3 molar NaCl solution is filled in this electrode. And here PTFE tubing is there. This PTFE is polytetrafluoroethylene. This PTFE is also known as Teflon. So here Teflon tubing is there, and it is shrinkable with heat, and after that it is attached with porous fit, that is porous glass, for dipping in the electrolyte solution. So this is the complete setup of silver chloride electrode. So here by using this AG wire, electron conduction takes place, and it will flow as a current, and here gold plated contact will be there, so it will be contact with another half cell. So this is the complete setup of silver chloride electrode. And how reaction takes place in this silver chloride electrode? So it is a redox type of electrode, means oxidation also takes place and reduction also takes place. So first I am taking the example of reduction. If reduction takes place in this electrode, so Ag plus will gain an electron, and it will convert into Ag metal. Now coming to the next reaction, if oxidation takes place, then what will be the half reaction? So if oxidation takes place, then Ag will give an electron, and it will convert into the form of Ag plus. So this is the working and details about AgCl electrode. Thank you.